السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. As we go through these special days, we come to talk about another special and important topic, that is the takbir, the making remembrance of Allah and saying Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greater, Allah is the greatest. We find in the Quran that the takbir is associated with Eid, the both Eids, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, the Eid after Ramadan and Eid which we slaughter in. Both Eids are associated with takbir, as Allah says, وَلَتُكْمِرُ الْعِدَّةُ وَلَتُكْبِرُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, where Allah told us after you complete your rituals of fasting during the month of Ramadan, then let you glorify Allah, make remembrance of Allah by saying takbir, saying Allahu Akbar. And this goes for both Eid, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. Of course, what we're going to speak about today is not just the takbir that is associated with Eid al-Adha, but also the takbir that is associated with the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. So that's what we're going to speak about first, is when should we start making takbir? Should this be associated only with Eid, or should this be associated also with the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days which we are in right now? Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, he had given his verdict with regards to this. As he said, may Allah be pleased with him, the 10 days that are mentioned, because Allah mentioned in the Quran, 2 10 days. Make remembrance of Allah في أيام المعلومات. Okay, واذكروا الله في أيام المعلومات واذكروا الله في أيام المعدودات. Make remembrance of Allah in the known days. Make remembrance of Allah in the counted days. So what is the known days and what are the counted days? So these are two set of days that Allah mentions in the Quran. So Ibn Abbas said, the known days are the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah which we are in. And the days, the counted days, these are the days of Tashriq, or the days of Eid, which is the 4 days of Eid that we have. So these are the completing together 13 days of Takbir, which we should be making Takbir in. Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, narrates with regards to this of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he used to go out for both Eids. He goes out with his family members, with Al-Fadl, with Abdullah ibn Abbas, with Ali, with Ja'far, with Al-Hasan al-Husayn, his grandchildren, his cousins, Usama ibn Zayd, the freed slave of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and different family members of his, making takbir and making tahleel, saying La ilaha illallah and saying Allahu Akbar out loud, raising his voice with it. So now that we know when the takbir should begin and when should it end, let's speak about this manners of takbir. The takbir should be said with one voice. If people are sitting in groups, should it be said together or should it be said separately? There is difference. There is some of the scholars, a small group of the scholars, where they say that the takbir is not to be said in groups, but rather it should be said individually. So instead of a group of people together saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar together, rather this should be said individualized. But what we see from the hadith reported to us about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or what the companions used to do, Ibn Umar and Umar ibn Khattab and the likes of which, that the takbir, there was no specification whether it was said together or separate, and it seems to be more that it was said together. The people used to say the takbir following Abdullah ibn Umar or following Umar ibn Khattab with their takbir. So it seems like that it was said together. And saying that this is an innovation where the people say it together, there's not really clear proof on this matter. So therefore, when the people say in the takbir together, there's no problem with this, inshallah, for the lack of the evidence for that. The next point we want to speak about is the saying the takbir out loud. Previously, as we just mentioned in the last two narrations, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say his takbir out loud. The companions used to say the takbir out loud. So therefore, we should say our takbir out loud. And Ibn Umar used to be, when he's doing his Hajj, and on the days of Mina, when he's staying in Mina, this is after Eid, so the 3 days of Tashriq, or the next 3 days, the continuing of Eid, he would make takbir out loud while he's sitting in his tent, and the people around him would make takbir out loud with him. We also have the same similar reports about Umar, the father of Ibn Umar, where he used to do the same thing, saying the takbir out loud. So therefore, this seems to be the way of the companions. Abdullah ibn Abbas did this, and other companions as well did this, saying the takbir out loud. So therefore, we should say our takbir out loud. And this is also what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did when he was going out for his Eid prayers, whether it was the Eid al-Adha or Eid al-Fitr. He would say his takbir out loud, And tahleel, as we mentioned, saying la ilaha illallah. So therefore, that should be said out loud, but not not to the individual saying it to himself. The next point here is the takbir. When should it be made? When it should be done? Should it be done? The scholars split takbir into two categories: a specified takbir, which is the one done after the five daily prayers. And there is the general takbir, which is we do throughout the day and whatever we're doing. We don't have anything tracing back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us when exactly should we do takbir, but we do follow what the general Muslims have done since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They used to do takbir after the daily prayers, okay, from the time of the companions and time of tabi'in and so on and so forth. So that's why we do takbir after the five daily prayers. How many takbir should we do? Now you find that generally people do three times. So saying like the Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Alhamd, saying that three times. We don't have a specific number tracing back, again, because it's one with the lack of reports to the back to tracing back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So therefore, if the person just does takbir after the five daily prayers, then he would be following what the ummah had done since the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam. This is done after the five daily prayers, beginning from the first night of Eid all the way until the end of Eid. We're talking about Eid al-Adha here. What is the first night of Eid? This starts from the Maghrib on the day before Eid and ends on the Asr of the fourth day of Eid. So the Maghrib on the day before Eid and the Asr of the last day of Eid. Why the Maghrib? Because the night in Islam comes before the day. So the Maghrib that is coming on a day before Eid, that is the night of Eid actually, and that's why we start our takbir from that time. And then it ends all the way on the fourth day of Eid, at the end of that fourth day. When is the fourth day? The Asr prayer, which is the last prayer before the day ends, because the day ends at the time of Maghrib. As for the general takbir, the companions used to do the general takbir throughout the time and in different places. So in the marketplaces, when they laying down in their beds, doing different things throughout their day, they would be making takbir out loud. And this was the action of Ibn Umar, this was the action of Abu Huraira, this is the action of different companions. They used to do that same thing, saying takbir aloud. This is during the 10 days, during the Eid prayer, during the days after Eid, the 4 days of Eid. The days of Tashriq. So throughout this entire 13 days, they would continue to do that. And that's why we should be doing the takbir out loud in different times and different places. Finally, what is the actual wording of takbir? We find that again, there is no specific wording tracing back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We don't have none, but we do have some reports from companions like Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, like Ibn Abbas, like Salman al-Farisi. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, for example, had narrated to us the famous one that we always do in during Eid, which is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. Ibn Abbas reported to us a different one, which is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, three Allahu Akbars, Walillahi alhamd, Allahu Akbar wa ajal, Allahu Akbar ala ma hadana. So this is another narration or another way of saying the takbir narrated to us by Ibn Abbas. There is a third way, which is narrated to us by Salman, which is Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar kabira. So these are three authentic ways that have been narrated to us that we can say takbir in. And certainly the matter is pretty open. As we see there, this is works of some of the companions. We don't have nothing tracing back to Allah or the Prophet ﷺ. So therefore the takbir is, it's kind of open as long as the individual is making takbir of Allah. But we can pick one of these ways to make takbir of Allah, whether it's the first, second or third. They're all okay that we can make takbir in. A quick recap on everything is that the takbir first begins from the first day, from the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, and ends all the way at the last day of Eid, from the 4 days of Eid, the 3 days of Tashriq coming after Eid, so the 13th day, okay, of Dhul-Hijjah, the Asr of that. That's when the takbir ends, and it begins from all the way the first day of the 10 days. And we said also that the takbir should be done out loud. It can be done in a group or an individual. individualized. Takbir should be done in every place and every time throughout the days. Whatever we are, we do the takbir. There are three different ways that we can say takbir, and all of them are authenticated and all of them are acceptable that we can make takbir in. And the matter is pretty open since we don't have a clear instructions of how to do it from the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We ask Allah to make these days a blessed days for us, and we ask Allah to accept our deeds during these days. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.